Debugging a Linux kernel module and a user process with a Trace32JTAG debugger. This video will present some key Trace32 features for debugging the Linux operating system. We will show you how to debug over JTAG the interaction between a user process and a kernel module. Please note that all the actions shown in this video can be automated using a practice script file. We use in this video a Trace32 PowerView version of May 2080 with a Power Debug Pro connected to a Panda board, which has an OMAP4430 processor running a Linux 4.40 kernel. The Linux demo is running here on an SMP system consisting of two Cortex-A4 cores. I use here the following practice script to connect to the target and configure the Linux aware debugging. Key for the Trace32 Linux debugging is that the Trace32 Linux awareness, which is an extension that Lauterbach provides for its debuggers, is loaded during the setup. The script additionally adds a Linux menu to Trace32 PowerView, which includes many useful items to ease Linux aware debugging. I will now start the script. In this example, the Linux kernel, as well as the device tree blob and the file system, are downloading to the target memory using the debugger. As you can see, the Linux menu is now added to Trace32 PowerView. I have prepared for this video an IMAP example for transferring data between user space and kernel space using a kernel module and a user application. The Trace32 Linux awareness allows to debug kernel modules from the start. To do so, select the Trace32 menu Linux, Module Debugging, Debug Module on Init. A dialog will pop up. We just need to enter the name of the kernel module without extension as stated. We can optionally send a command to the Trace32 terminal window by selecting this checkbox and enter the command here. By pressing OK, the kernel module will be loaded and the program execution will be stopped as soon as the init function is called. The debug symbols of the kernel module are automatically loaded by Trace32. You can see from the task module window that our kernel module is loaded. For better visibility, Trace32 marks the code section of kernel modules with yellow, while the kernel itself is marked with red. The init function of our kernel module creates a new procfs entry called a map file. I will set breakpoints at the entry of the map and open functions. We can debug the entry function of the kernel module using single steps. The new procfs entry is now created. You can simply check this using the Trace32 menu Linux, Display File System, Display Proc. The Trace32 Linux awareness additionally allows to debug user processes from the start. I will debug my user application by selecting the menu Linux, Process Debugging, Debug New Process. A dialog will appear. I just need to enter the name of the process and the function where the execution should be stopped after the process creation. I will keep the proposed main function. I will additionally use the dialog to send the command for starting the process to the Trace32 term window. My process takes the mmap file as parameter. As soon as the process is started, 332 will automatically load its debug symbols and stop the execution at the main function. The code range for the user space is marked with green. The task process window shows that our process is started and is the current task on core 0. We can debug our process by single-stepping the execution. The following line will open the file created by the kernel module. This will call the open function defined by the kernel module. The frame window shows the execution stack from the kernel module back to the user space. The open function will allocate a buffer in the kernel space, which is pointed by the data item of the infrastructure. We can see the virtual to physical address mapping of the allocated buffer using the command MMU list page table. I will resume now the execution to go back to the user process. We can see that the file has been opened by our process by doing a right mouse click on the process name in the task process window and select Display Detailed, then expand Open Files. Now we will use the mmap function to create a new mapping in the virtual address space of our process. This will call the mmap function defined by the kernel module. This function will define the following virtual memory map functions. I will set a breakpoint at the fault function. Let's return now to the user process. We can check here the allocated address. As you can see here, we get an NMU fail error when trying to read at this address. This is a normal behavior because of the undimmed paging mechanism used by Linux. The memory page will only be loaded when it's accessed for the first time. We can check the virtual to physical mapping for this address by reading the page table of the current process using the following command. As you can see, our address does not have for the moment a virtual to physical address mapping. Let's try now to access the memory pointed by this address by printing its content as string. Since it is the first attempt to access this memory page, the VM fault function will be called. This function will trigger the loading of the memory page and create a virtual to physical address mapping. As you can see, the user space and the kernel space addresses of the buffer are mapped to the same physical address. The main difference between both mappings is that the kernel address cannot be accessed by the user. As you can see, using Trace32J Tag Debugger and the Linux awareness, we have access to the total system memory. This gives us the possibility to debug all Linux components at the same time, including the kernel, kernel modules, as well as user processes and libraries. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. The Trace32 Linux awareness has, however, more features. For more details, I invite you to look at the following documents. Thanks for watching.